God bless you all my people. So I'm not gonna stay here for long. It's been a while since I showed up live on Facebook. So today we're gonna be talking about some important information, some important message that we need to hear. God bless you, and I want to wish all our daddies Happy Father's Day. Hi, yay, yay. Happy Father's Day. Ah, yeah. Me, we no get papa. My dad is late, so I would like to celebrate all the daddies in the house. God bless you. We thank God for your life. We thank God for your family. So today, the reason why I am here today, this is really important, okay? Even the ones that don't have no children, I wish you Happy Father's Day, because I know soon you will have yes. Okay, it does not matter how long you've been waiting. When that time comes, when God said it is your time to be a father, you will be. So today I want to talk about fathers. I know a lot of us know the meaning of father, what it takes to be a father and all that, but I'm here today because of Father's Day, okay? And there is this message that I wanted to pass across for our fathers. It's time for us to reset. It's time for us to reset. And if you are a father out there that you're doing a good job, you do what you're supposed to be doing as a father, I carry hand for you. I carry hand for you. If I feel raise my nyash up, I go raise for you. But well, all I can do right now is I celebrate you, daddy. I celebrate all your effort. I celebrate your love for your children. I celebrate your love for your wife, for whoever is in your life, for your girlfriend, for your lady. I just want to talk about this. Hold on, just a moment. Okay, I just want to talk about this because the reason why I'm here is because the way our daughters and our sons accept some issues when it have to do with their daddy not being there or their daddy's not in their life, it's like I'm really disturbed, okay? And of course my dad is late, so there are times whereby I wish I had the opportunity to bond with my daddy. I wish I had the opportunity to bond with my dad before he died, but I did not. Okay? But the few weeks or months that I got to spend with my dad, I really appreciate everything that he did. Okay? I appreciate everything that he did, the love, the way he took care of me and everything. I appreciate it, okay? It does not matter how long my dad was in my life for. It does not really matter. It's what the things that he did while he was still alive. So, a lot of people are getting this Happy Father's Day, Happy Father's Day. Yes, Happy Father's Day. Today is Father's Day. But there is something that I really want us, our father, there's something that I really want our father to understand. Think about the reason why people are wishing you happy fathers. The reason why you are a daddy. The reason why you are called father. Because there are a lot of people out there that they are so excited. Yes, I have a child. I have a son. I have a daughter. But is a lot going on in the life of your son and in the life of your daughters, but you are not involved in their life. I'm saying this because especially for our sons, it does not matter. The way I say it is, majority of some of the daddy out there that are no longer or that are not involved in their sons or their daughter's life, you know, that we always blame the mother, okay? that we always blame the mother. But I don't really support when a father or when a two couple are no longer together, but there is a child involved. I believe that regardless of whatever the reason is that you separated with your spouse or with your girlfriend or with your, I don't like using this word baby mama, I don't like using it. You know, I feel more comfortable saying the mother of your child. You know, today I'm talking about men, okay? Maybe some other time, if God permits me, we'll talk about the mothers. But today I want to talk about the fathers, daddies. Okay, whether you are married, whether you are a single man, you know, when you are no longer with your partner that you have a child with, it does not mean that the father have no right to see the child, okay? But majority of the time, I don't know about other women, okay? I don't know about other women, but there are some women that because of the pain or whatever it is that they went through with the father, they care less. The fact that the father abandoned the child for the mother and the mother not take whatever it is, carry that responsibility of being a mother to care for this child, you know, and the dad is not there. The dad does not really care what happened to the child, how the child eats, the welfare of the child, you know. The mother take the frustration and deny the father seeing the child because they felt like, if I'm here doing all of this to make sure this child have life or to make sure that this child is well taken care of and you careless and all of a sudden you want to show up out of nowhere, want to be in the life of the child. When the child are little, it's very easy for the child to understand that, okay, this is my daddy. I want to go be with daddy. I want to go hang out with daddy. But when they are big boys, like, man, these kids, they are not grown, okay? They don't care. They don't care. Of all of a sudden, you want to show up to be a daddy. These kids, they don't care. They are no longer kids. Now they are grown. They will not give a hoot of whether you realize that you made a mistake or not. This child, I keep calling them a child, but I'm talking about now that they are grown, they will never look at you. Okay? But I'm not really supportive of a woman or for the mother withholding the child from the dad. But when you look at the reason why the woman make that decision,
when I think about it,
okay, because they say monkey they walk, baby they chop. I don't know how they make that parable, but I just felt like it's not fair for any mother to go through. You don't care how this woman care for this child. You don't care whether this woman sold her body to take care of this child. You don't care if this woman sold part of her, whatever you call it, just to take care of this child. You don't care, and all of a sudden you want to show up and be a father. Being a father, just showing up, but your contribution, no. It doesn't make no sense.
But
I was watching a movie yesterday,
and
this guy came to the hospital to see his dad. And his dad, I guess, he's really, really sick. And the news got to this guy and he find out that his dad was really sick and he showed up at the hospital and his dad have all this, whatever you can think of, was really, really rich. And this guy went to the hospital to see his dad. And the dad, all he wanted to do is just to kind of express how he missed the child and all that. Remember, this is no longer a little boy that you are talking to. This is a grown-up boy. Even at the age of 2-3, I understand, but when they are getting to the age of, I don't know, to me, some kids, when they are getting to the age of maybe 6-7, they know everything. Whether you show up, the days you don't show up, and all that, they remember everything that you did and you did not do. So when they grow up to become a grown-up adult like that, there is no word you would tell them to convince them. because they have evidence. No matter how, sometimes some dad will say, okay, it's your mom. Your mom is the reason why I did not show up. Your mom is the reason why I did not do this. Your mom is the reason why I did not do that. Close the door, please. You know, but these kids, they are grown to understand and see the gap. Even though you did not show up when they were little, but when they were grown, when they are like about 16, 17, maybe 15, 16, 17 and upward, and they are not seeing you, you can't be telling them that is the mom. Because at that age, they can make some certain decision at that age. Of course, when they are 18, they are not adults. They can do whatever they want to do. They can make decisions by themselves. But at that young age of maybe 15, 16, 17, the mother cannot tie their hand or stop them from seeing their parents. No, because they have a voice. You understand? So when these kids are that age and they're not seeing you, they are not seeing your involvement, they are not, you are not helping them financially, you are not investing, you are always distant physically, you're not showing up, you don't talk to them on the phone, no word of encouragement, you don't do anything with them, then all of a sudden, you want to say good words to them when they are grown. No. You know? But this movie I was talking about, this boy went to the hospital to see his dad, and in the hospital bed, he was asking his dad for money. After the dad kind of showed how sad he felt that he was not able to see him and all that, and this child is requesting for money from him in the hospital bed, the child just couldn't, the father couldn't process it. It was too hard for him to just accept that, okay, that is all this boy have to say. And this boy was like, Dad, I'm sorry. I can't pretend that I have any feelings for you. Yes, you are my daddy and I'm here because I really need help from you. But I cannot pretend that I have feelings for you. Because of that, this man just couldn't process what came out of his son's mouth, and he took a deep breath, and that was it. He died. Still, during the funeral, the child didn't show up for the funeral, and I felt so bad when I saw that. So, fathers, it's time for a reset. It's time for a reset. I don't know what the mother of your child or your girlfriend or your wife or your ex-wife that did to you, but if relationship is not working with you and your partner, does not mean you should ghost out on your child. And again, when you take that child as a secondary, like the child is not important to you because the child is still young, he don't know no better. And we are always used to saying this word, is my child, when he grow up, he will look for me. That is not always true. That is not always true. It's not. I'm saying this because a lot of our sons out there, they are the way they are, not a lot of them, some of them, they are the way they are because of what they felt their daddy did to their mother, and some of them start acting like their daddy. There are some father out there that when they were young, there was no adult, no, there was no, they don't have anybody that they look up to. They don't have anybody that tell them, oh, you're doing this wrong, you're doing this right. So they were just basically just doing things on their own, based on their own understanding, you know. And when they grow up and get married and start having children, they think that, okay, I did not, my father did not do this for me, my daddy did not do this for me. So you growing up too, what's the difference? You can do the same thing that I did. They expect that the child is going to follow that pattern. At the end of the day, they're taking care of themselves. And when these children grow up, they will grow up to be the same, they will grow up to copy the same pattern that the daddy, the father,
the behavior, everything
that the father was doing, some of the sons that will grow up and copy the same pattern and going to marriage, going to relationship, raising a child, just that with that same pattern of behavior. You know,
fathers,
I celebrate you now. Let me speak pidgin now. I celebrate you now where we're happy Father's Day. We really need to understand that the reason why we are called fathers is because of our children, the sons and the daughters that you have. So if God give you this opportunity and you were able to have a child that you call your own, even the ones that don't have their own, I still celebrate you now, like I said previously. But if you have the opportunity to have your own, the one you call your own,
the one you call your own,
whether in a previous relationship or in the new relationship,
please, one thing you should never do is to abandon
your child. Do not
abandon
your child for nobody. It doesn't matter who it is. Because these children, when you are getting old, these children, you will need
them tomorrow.
You will need them tomorrow. You can't depend on your brothers. You can't depend on your sisters. Because that's just life. People will turn back on you. Even the ones you think that they are your blood, they will turn back on you. But your child
will always remember you.
But the roles that you play in the life of that child goes a long way. The decision you make today, think about
tomorrow.
Now, this is not about the mother. This
is about you and that
child. What role are you playing in the life of that child? Don't expect that child to follow the same pattern or whatever you went through in the past. Don't expect that child to follow the same, especially if it's not a good one. Especially if it's not. You know, we as a woman, we easily let go. We easily say, okay, now my papa, let me just, is my father, is my father. What can I do? You know?
It's my father. But
for male child, they don't care. Male child, they don't care. They don't care.
They don't at all.
You see, the worst part of it, the one thing you don't want to do is that child that you abandon. God do it and everything is not okay with that child.
The child is not like a
from the person, like he's a famous person. Now all of a sudden, you want to show up in his life. Every child acts differently. But there are some child that will not accept that. They will even embarrass you in public.
So the decision you make
now in the life of that child goes a long way. And it's one thing that is so sad. So, so sad. When a father thinks that it's okay for a child to struggle on his own, to survive.
Especially when that
child is still a minor. It's not okay.
If it's not working
between you and the mother of this child, it's not working. But that's not the end of the world. Your involvement in the life of the child matters a lot.
It matters. Whatever
took place between you and the mother has nothing to do with the child.
Has nothing to do with the child.
It
think about tomorrow when you are making your today decisions. It might be all rosy, sweet, and nice. You're moving on. You want to start life all over again. And you think that this child that you left behind will be okay. With the help of God, yes, this child will be okay. But think about tomorrow. Because you never know what will happen to you tomorrow. That is. You never know what condition you will be in tomorrow. You don't know who will help you tomorrow. When you are making today's decision, think about tomorrow. So I'm talking about whether you had a previous relationship and you are now in a new relationship. In that previous relationship, you have a child and it didn't work out between you and the father or the mother. Now, in this new relationship that you are in, you still have a child. I don't understand any woman that will accept you happily knowing that you don't take care of your child, your previous relationship, the child that you have there, and she accepts you. It's whatever you did in that previous relationship with that child, it's the same thing you're going to do in this new relationship. To me, that's the way I see it. If you abandon your children in a previous relationship and you came to another relationship thinking that the woman is doing you right, like I said, today is not all about women. Today is not all about women, is all about the men. Okay, if you think you have found a good, which you don't know how tomorrow will be with you and that good, all I'm concerned about is the children that you are having from one to one, from one to one, from one to one. Be responsible. Be willing to take care of all these children. All these children with the shit from one to one to one to one. Be ready to take care of them. Stop running away and leaving these children, leaving responsibility for the woman to carry alone. I am not bashing on you guys, so I'm taking it easy, but this is just the fact. And the reason why I'm really doing this is because of the innocent children that are involved in it. Because when they grow up tomorrow, just like the way you abandon them, these children will abandon you. They won't even look back. It's easy for women to easily, for the female children to easily let go. But the male child, they will use your eyes, see when. You won't even believe this is your own blood.
Fathers.
Every year when you are being celebrated, happy Father's Day. Think about the reason why you are being celebrated. Don't be carried away by the today celebration. Think about tomorrow. Don't be carried away. There are fathers, there are some men out there that are desperate to have a child and they don't have. Which I know at the right time, God will visit them. But the ones that have the opportunity to even have child, some of them, they don't even want to have nothing to do with their child. No matter how poor you think you are, no matter how poor you think you are, you know your situation before you decided to have a child. You know you don't have whatever it takes, but you still want to have a child, and you have a child. You knew your situation. You knew that you don't have you don't have the money. See, one thing I cannot stand is when a man said, I don't have money. You don't have money, but you were able to pregnant the woman that you are involved with. You pregnanted this woman. You are happy that you guys are having a child. In the midst of going through it, living life, all of a sudden, you will just disappear in the life, from the life of that woman or from the life of that child. And what you use as an excuse is, I don't have money right now. Things are hard. Things are this. No. When you had that child, things were hard. So why can't you fight your way through to make things okay? Why do you have to abandon that child because things are not okay? Father, please,
it's time to reset. This is not about you and the mother of the child now. This is about you and the child that you call your own. The reason why you are being crowned right now, being celebrated, Happy Father's Day. Think about that child. Think about that child. There are innocent sons out there, especially, I'm talking about male child now. The things that all this male child go through without father. And you'll be blaming them. Sometimes we cannot blame them. It's what their father did. Some of them will. I'm not saying this is an opportunity for any male child to go out there and misbehave. But some of these male child, they copy from the behavior of their father.
It's not all fathers
that are like that. The majority of all this male child that are acting the way they are acting, just walking away from relationship, walking away from marriage. They don't care about the feelings of the child. They don't care the impact of their decision, what it's going to do to the child. They don't care. They just easily walk away like that. Then you'll be blaming the mother. What about you?
It's not all about the mother.
It's about two of you. When you make a decision to have a child, do whatever you have to do to create a better image for that child. To carry on to their whatever. See, when you know that, they're talking about generational curse. I'm not going to talk about that. So I'll leave that for another time. When you already know the pattern that you followed when you were little, okay? To me, I don't know about you. But to me, if I already know the pattern that is going on in my family and I want to break it, not all of them that is generational cause. Some of them is just selfishness. Some of them is I don't care. Some of them is a lot of reason why a lot of men are just leaving their marriage without even considering, not only marriage, leaving their children for the mothers to take care of. Just because some of them, selfishness. They don't even think about the child when they walk away.
They don't think about the child.
They don't think about how this thing is going to affect the child. Today, you are being celebrated. Happy Father's Day. Me too. Odeerih, I join you celebrate. Oh, I celebrate you well. Happy Father's Day. Mom will put the crown for your head. But the responsibility, you're running away from it. Now, this one is not for all men. So if you come on my on this comment, whatever, and comment nonsense, you're on your own. Me, I don't send anybody at all.
I don't send anybody.
These are innocent kids that did not ever ask to be here. You think you can just come and just pregnant a woman that you say you love or you whatever, I don't know what it is, and you have a child and you just abandon that child with a woman for the woman to raise, take care of, for the woman to take care of the child. When the child becomes somebody today, then you won't carry your coats, carry your belt, your pants where you pull all the way to your belly. They come say I'm the father. No, it does not work that way. I'm here pleading. To some of the fathers out there, if you know you are this person that I'm talking about, you are part of these fathers that I'm talking about. If relationship is not working, it's not working. That's understandable. It's not a do or die. But one thing I'm pleading for is consider that child, that boy, that little boy, that little girl, that you walk away from. Walking away from the mom, it's okay. It's life. But walking away from that child just because it didn't work out between you and the mom. And the most painful part of it, a lot of things that some men do, let me not be using men, so it won't look like I'm talking to all the men. Some things that some of the men do,
the thing that was,
they pregnant this woman, is a goal that should be celebrating, that, oh, the man pregnant me or my husband pregnant. No. you did it so two of us can team together and raise this child. We are supposed to come together and raise this child. But I don't want to do that. If it's not working with you and them, they will leave you and the child alone. Please, this is not nice. This is not nice. If you are one of these fathers doing things like doing this, all this, if you are one of these fathers that is acting this way, it's time to reset for your good, for your tomorrow. For your good, for your tomorrow. There are a lot of men out there at the nursing home that they will have nobody coming to see them. No, it's not like they don't have children, no, they do. But who know why these kids are not coming to see the fathers them in the nursing home? Who knows? Father, please. It's time for you guys to resettle. If relationship not work between you and your mama, it's not the end of the world. But what you need to do your best to take care of your sons. Do your best to take care of your daughters. Because you don't expect the mom to carry the load alone. Then tomorrow, you want to be celebrated for being their father. You want to be recognized for being their father. Huh? I don't want to say you are a sperm donor. I don't believe that. Now, situation make things, make crayfish get K-leg. But that is not your portion. But it's time for you guys to reset. Do things right. Rethink things over before you make decision. Okay? So this is what I want to talk about today regarding men. Men that are fathers. And I know those that are still yet to be a father, please think twice before you make decision. Before you say you want to have a child, make sure you wish well for that child you are planning to have. Make sure you have plans for that child you are planning to have. Okay? Do not let selfishness make you make a decision that will affect that child or that is not of God. Please, do right for your sons and your daughters. So tomorrow, the celebration you are getting now, the happy Father's Day you are getting now, it will be more tomorrow for you to enjoy. Because all this one we are doing now, happy Father's Day, it's just for the now. It's just for now. Tomorrow. Tomorrow is right in the corner knocking. So my fathers, I celebrate you, those that are doing what they are supposed to be doing, how God expects them to do it, and they are doing it perfectly. I celebrate una. I carry crown. I celebrate una. Okay? I celebrate every one of you. If you know that you are doing what you're supposed to be doing, happy Father's Day. And for you that are not doing what you're supposed to be doing, I still wish you happy Father's Day, because I believe that the God that we serve is a forgiving God. And I pray that He will touch your heart to do the right thing towards your sons and your daughters. May God bless you. May God really, really bless you. Thank you so much. And I love you. No offense, oh, no offense at all. But this is the fact, reality. Please. If you don't work with you and mama, does not mean no work between you and your children. Do what you're supposed to do. No cheating. If you think you do today, you don't do again till 3 years later. The kids, they are watching. Just hearing your voice alone is not enough. You can do more than them just hearing your voice. Okay? God bless you. I love you. Bye.